deep in West Texas. One oil rig is in a battle with itself.
I'm gonna punch you, motherfucker!
Get ready to work!
Get on the floor!
We don't work at banks.
Don't talk about me, motherfucker!
We don't work at the mall.
Get out of here! Dude.
I mean, we work in living hell.
They'll endure pain.
Look out!
And exhaustion. As they attempt the impossible.
Drilling four holes in 50 days, man, that's gonna be tough.
Now the pressure's building.
Hey, watch out!
They can kill and eat each other, as far as I'm concerned.
And they'll keep on fighting.
Come on, sir, let's get it out!
Just for a taste.
Long drill, baby! Love it! Love it and want some more of it!
Of black gold.
Previously on Black Gold.
Get a break!
Rig 28 got a surprise visit from the boss.
5-minute walk, and I can tell you if people on the rig are doing their job or not.
The pressure of the job boiled over.
I'm gonna beat the f*** out of somebody. I feel right now.
Drink too much, mother.
The second hole was completed.
A TD right there, man. That's two down, two more to go.
But the thirds.
You're saying that, you know, oh, we're gonna have a hell of a trouble with this hole.
Going to be a well from hell.
I dreamed about this last night. I don't know what's gonna happen.
Today, day shift driller Pee Wee's working the floor.
What up, man? Turn up and get a stuck.
Pee Wee's working a little sucker. He's a good hand.
Awesome.
Bitches a lot, but everybody does.
He's letting floorhand Chuck work his driller to nurse an infected arm.
Chuck's got a staph infection in his arm.
Arm sore, but I feel fine. Watch out, yo.
They took him to a doctor a couple of days ago, and they seem to let him come back to work with that.
Roughnecks don't take days off when they get sick. Roughnecks don't get sick days that don't shut down.
I know everybody needs the money and everything, but the rest of us don't need to be sick with your either.
It's very, very contagious. You know, I think pretty gross. You know, Chuck walking around with an IV in his arm.
We're just gonna let him run the rig and drill a hole in the ground day while I roughneck so he don't mess that IV or nothing else up. We just gotta cover each other's ass.
Now, Pee-wee's stuck throwing the tongs with Worm Cheston.
Someday, Cheston, someday.
Shut up.
Someday, son.
On a day like creep, a lot of weight on your shoulders, especially when they give you guys like they give me to work with.
I'm just here to look pretty, remember?
Veteran Gerald's been doing what he can to teach the worm.
Cheston's been a little froggy, so everybody just kind of rides his ass. Everybody gets irritated because he won't try hard enough.
Pick them tongs up. Cheston.
You know, a 50% hand out here ain't worth a damn.
$1 million operation waiting on time.
We're looking for 110% all the time, and if we don't get it, we're gonna ride your ass.
Come on, you're killing me. You're gonna fuck me out of 40 foot today.
One thing doesn't go right, you know, it's all Cheston's fault, you know?
It's really kind of annoying, you know? It's like, keep your mouth shut, do your job.
After 3 weeks on Big Dog 28, it looks like Cheston still can't latch the tongs.
That'd be the day.
Damn!
Nice spring, folks. Pee-wee.
Up.
Got a busted spring in him.
Should have new springs, man.
I mean, after all that screaming and hollering, obviously something's wrong with them. You know, they're not latching. Something's got to be wrong with them.
Busted spring in him.
Well, it wasn't my fault.
Get the f*** on the floor!
Now Pee-wee's gotta grudgingly admit that the worm isn't always to blame.
He's not ever gonna be a bright hand, but he's done a lot better. I mean, don't tell him I said that. Take your tongs and make sure, get your tongue guys cleaned up real good. Just get them ready.
So they'll really bite?
Yeah. That way he ain't gonna work so hard.
It's almost shift change time at Big Dog 28. And night crew driller Ron is already on site.
He's still tracing out them lights?
Don't tell him, don't worry about him. I'll get the electrician out here. All right. Fix him tomorrow.
Grab my lunch now.
But he's got no idea he's about to lose his best roughneck. Today will be Floorhand Cody's last day.
I love you.
You did too.
One of my friends, he offered me a daylight drilling job. I mean, it's way more money. And in daylights, I could come home at 2, get off at 2, and come home, see my family, eat dinner with them and everything, spend way more time with them. So it's promotion, better raise. I gotta do what's best for me and my family.
But what's best for Cody isn't what's best for Ron.
I got a job offer for this other company, and I got to start tomorrow or they're not gonna hire me.
Yeah, couldn't give me no more notice than this.
I wish I could. I told him, man, I didn't want to leave you in a bind.
You know, once you leave, you'll be replacing it.
It'd be hard to get back on here. I know, Ron. It's just something I had to do. I love working for you, man. You're a good guy. I mean, I consider you like a friend, too, but I just need to spend more time with my kids.
Oh, yeah, if you got your mind made up, then hey, there ain't really much I can do about it.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I appreciate it, Ron.
Yeah. Stay in touch with me, though.
Yes, sir, I sure will. I can still get your number, Ron.
All right. Always, always home. You know, he's one of my better hands, so it kind of sucks losing him and everything.
Back in Midland, Cheston's finally starting to make friends with the day crew. Max looking to have fun, but Cheston's looking for reassurance.
Obviously, I'm doing a better job. Y'all just know what to tell me.
Coming out in the open field and getting a compliment every time you do something right, that ain't gonna happen.
I know,
you
I
don't
know.
Expect that to any of y'all. Anytime you ever ask me, it's like a girl fishing for a compliment. How do you think I look tonight?
How do I look?
The less we yell at you, the better you're doing.
Just when Cheston's starting to bond with his crew,
You still got your moments where you got to think. You step back and you're like,
I wouldn't expect not to. You know, it's like.
He breaks an unwritten roughneck rule.
Our driller makes me want to look stupid out there, dude. He's the one that told me, he said, when it gets tight, throw it. That, dude.
Don't talk smack about the driller behind his back.
I don't care.
I'm not your little messenger boy.
Whatever you got to say, you say to him.
I already am.
Then there you go. Why are you telling me? Because this is a driller. You ain't doing your job right. Don't think you ain't going to come down on your ass like that.
Don't get mad.
I'm not getting mad. I'm tired of hearing I'm tired of hearing I could care less about
what's going on. I don't care either.
Then why in the hell bring this up to me? That's y'all's thing. That's y'all. Y'all button heads. I don't need to hear that. That is pointless.
Are you still talking about me?
Then why in the did you bring
that? Are you still?
Exactly. Shut it up. And I don't want to hear the let it go.
Okay,
coming up, the big dog screeches to a halt, putting everyone's job at risk.
Damn it, I don't want to pull that shaft.
With the clock ticking to complete the final two holes and save their jobs, driller Pee-wee and the day crew are pushing the rig and themselves to the limit.
Just sit there and do all that hollering and yelling at each other.
And the pressure's tearing the crew apart.
Day.
Better than I did yesterday. I feel all right. My arm's kind of sore, but they give me pain pills. I've been eating them.
With his infection under control, Chuck's back on the floor. And Pee-wee's back at the controls, driving the rig hard to finish their third well and make their goal of 4 wells in 50 days. But this time, Pee-wee may have pushed the rig too far.
We're trying to get it beat over there into second gear. That way we can go ahead and finish this part of the hole.
The door's got to be up. Give it, I don't want to pull that shaft.
A broken transmission has shut down the big dog.
All we have is first gear and third gear.
And alerted management to problems on the rig.
Well, the drillers that's running the rig, they're getting in too big of a hurry. That's the main problem.
But former driller Gerald has his own expert opinion.
Pee-wee is so gung-ho and in such a hurry all the time, they don't necessarily wait for everything to stop turning before they change the gears. Over the course of 2 days, they might have saved an hour to an hour and a half's worth of time, but now it's going to cost us 24 to 48 hours in repairs.
But that's time they don't have, so the main office takes a huge risk.
Put it in low gear, we're going to run it low and high.
What we're going to do, we're going to put it all back together and run without a second gear.
And that's what my boss just told me.
Don't kick it in, just roll it.
Big Dog 28 is drilling again, but now the old girl is crippled.
You're either going real slow or you're going really, really fast.
David, what do you think the problem is on them transmission?
Probably some of the crews is not letting the draw work stall out. They're just trying to get it into gear quicker. Just go ahead and watch the drillers and see which driller's not letting it stall out when they shift gears.
I'll keep an eye on them.
For now, Big Dog 28 will limp along like a wounded animal. But it's only a matter of time before the transmission problems catch up with it. Back in town, word of Cody quitting has reached the night crew.
Hey, what's the deal with Cody, bro? He's not gonna work with us no more or what?
I guess he got a drilling job on another rig.
Oh,
yeah,
shit.
That's a good thing, man. He's got kids, you know, more money.
And yeah, I bet, bro. He had been talking a lot about not getting to see his kids.
Cody was a cool mother, man.
Roughnecks trust each other with their lives. So the question is, who's replacing Cody? Yeah,
and you know, we're getting somebody new out here. And I mean, it's gonna suck,
I just hope
bro,
he's experienced, you know, dude.
When he comes on the rig, he may be a... Whatever happens. Saucy, we'll have to lay him down, boys.
That might not be as easy as Brandon thinks. The new guy, Tank, is an ex-con, ex-pro fighter from the streets of Chicago.
Got into boxing after I quit playing football.
I needed that violence.
A lot of roughnecks think they're fighters. It's a rough job, but a lot of them think that they're more than they are.
Saucy, we'll have to lay him down, boys.
As a 3-year veteran of the oil fields,
the new guy in the crew is the worm. They call him Worm, and I'm like, but I ain't a worm.
Tank's not planning to get pushed around.
You know, I did county jail time, but that's a rite of passage on some of these rigs. I'm aggressive, forceful, energetic, enthusiastic, seize the day. That's how I try to live.
In a few hours, he'll be fighting his way onto Rig 28. With the transmission damaged, Big Dog 28's moving at half speed. But the crew's in high gear. Except for Gerald.
Gerald, he's old, can't keep up with us.
Gerald's used to being driller and running his own rig.
I run this motherfucking crew.
But now he's struggling with his new job as derrick man.
Gerald come up yesterday to the doghouse, you know, and he wants somebody to swing a hammer for him.
When it's something to be done, it's everybody's job. It's not your job, my job. It's everybody's motherfucking job.
Well, hell, that's Gerald's job.
Today, he's overflowed the pits, further slowing the drilling down and putting everyone else's jobs at risk.
When we switched the pumps over a while ago, we didn't switch the valves, right? We got in a hurry, and we bumped the pit in full of water. There's too damn many derrick hands around here pulling valves, and
he's full of trying to cover his ass.
If you can't do the work out here, go back to that damn retirement home that you's living in.
I'll be all right. I mean, hell, I'm just old.
Not so much he's old, he's just not up to our standards.
Now Pee-wee's moving Gerald up to the floor, and he'll have to work with Cheston.
Hey, y'all get that screen out at five.
And the Worm's already gotten a dose of this old-timer's teaching methods.
I'm gonna bust your ass twice as hard as they do.
Yeah, I talk to you, I slapped you upside your head. Get your damn tongs over here, you worm.
They're not latched.
Well, they were.
Latch the motherfucker.
Over here, damn
tongs. Latch them. Don't slap me, latch them.
They're latched. Puss, take them back.
They were latched. Don't slap me. Focus on latching in my tongs.
You're gonna get one of us hurt.
Yeah, it's gonna be you, probably.
Hey, you need to keep your ass down there in the pitch. You're slowing us up.
Don't tell me to stay down there in the pitch.
Everybody else wanted me to tell you.
Okay.
Everybody else wanted me to tell you.
You tell that driller to tell me.
Just keep him down there in the pits, please. He said, I'm not gonna do it unless my driller tells me.
I told him he can do what he wants. I told him I like him to piss you off, so he can come up here all day long.
Why? That's stupid. That's stupid, dog.
No, it ain't.
He's gonna get his ass hurt. He touches me one more time, dude.
With his complaints falling on the driller's deaf ears, Cheston breaks another roughneck code and tattles to the tool pusher.
Cheston come to me. He said that when they made a connection, that Gerald had hit him in the hard hat or something like that.
If he puts his hands on me and the right person sees it, they're gonna run his ass off. I mean, you don't fight on the rig, you don't fight with your coworkers.
Oh, Cheston was running his mouth up there a while ago, and I reached across the damn pipe, slapped his glasses off his face.
If Freddie saw that, Freddie probably run him off.
It's just kind of a provoking thing.
He wanted to know what he could do about it, and I said, everybody needs to keep their hands to themselves because it just creates a problem, you know?
But I'm not gonna work next to somebody that's just gonna be disrespectful to me. Do not put your hands on me, you know? That you just don't do it.
But for now, the fight rages on.
I'm just kind of fed up to hear with them two hands. They're just another cutout for a day like their job. Not even a little bit.
And on.
I don't care. I don't care.
They're like two kids in a sandbox. You know, they're fighting over a toy or something.
If you stay down there, little bitch.
I
got a 70-year-old man and a retard.
Stay down there, little bitch. I mean, it's kind of hard with an old guy, a senior citizen, and a worm, you know.
No.
If you stay down there, you in your job.
You're good.
All we can do is just keep gritting our teeth. We just keep pushing through it.
It looks like Cheston and Gerald might settle this the old-fashioned way.
He's going to get his ass kicked one day.
We all know that we can't hit each other. If we're gonna fight, we gotta wait till we cross that cattle guard up there. Then we fall out in the ditch and get it on.
Cheston, he cries about everything.
But do not disrespect me. That's what it boils down to.
Gerald cries about everything.
He does not deserve to be in this oil field.
I'm just a damn babysitter out here for clowns like that.
I'm scared I can hit the guy so hard he'll give me an aneurysm or something.
Just go out there and do your job for 8 hours. Leave me the hell out of it. You know, if there's a major problem, the fat man will go out there and help you.
This is a real man's oil field, and if you ain't gonna work, get the f*** out.
Like my daddy said years ago, son, if you dumb today, you're gonna be dumb tomorrow. That's all there is to it.
At 2 p.m., it's shift change on Big Dog 28. Driller Ron and most of the night crew are hitting the rig.
Huh? Go that way.
The new guy, I don't know nothing about him.
But the new guy's MIA.
You need to be here at 1:30.
No, I haven't heard nothing from him on the telephone. I don't know who he's riding with. I don't know if his mama or grandma bringing him. I don't care.
So I'm going to have a new hand. Hopefully, you know, he can get along with everybody. And if he can't, then hell, he can go down the road. If he thinks he's going to come out here and cause trouble being a, we don't need that out here. And I'm not going to put up with it.
New floor hand Tank is one of the toughest and strongest roughnecks around.
That's south.
But yeah. Dependability,
turn left off highway,
has always been his Achilles heel.
Yeah, damn, I gotta go the other way.
You know, here it is almost straight up 2 o'clock and he still ain't here.
Well, being on time and stuff has It's always been kind of a little problem with me.
We gotta be out here at 2 o'clock. He wants a job, he'd be here at 2 o'clock.
It's raining now. I don't have a show wipers.
I should turn around.
He stayed at the house from now on for all I care.
New hands are always on a short leash. But showing up late on the first day jerks that choke chain even tighter.
A little hotter than the collar at me. I'm gonna have to really go about 10 times harder now and make a good impression. Adapt, adjust, and overcome. So here we go.
And the first guy to overcome is tool pusher Freddy.
First thing is, those steel toed?
Yes, sir.
You're sure about that?
I believe they are.
Step on them and see. They're not steel toed.
I'll have them tomorrow. Yes, sir.
You can't work out in unless you got steel toe shoes.
Can I borrow some shoes on there? From one of the guys.
So the new hand we got, Tank, no steel toed boots. You can't be wearing somebody else's stuff that creates problems.
Balls, man, you gonna fire me?
I'm not firing you. You can come back tomorrow, but you gotta get some steel-toed boots. I mean, if you've been a roughneck for 3 years, guy, you know that you gotta have a pair of them steel-toed boots on. That's just the way it is, you know? You gotta have your stuff to work with. I can't let you have somebody else's boots and they get all wet and soaking wet and stuff, and then they come back out here. Well, who the hell's been wearing my boots? And then we got a conflict. Yeah.
Thank you, Bob. Sorry.
On the rig, it's gone from bad to worse for Ron. Now he'll be working a man down.
I mean you was already late today.
I know, and it was because of them.
I can't help it. If they end up costing your job, that's not my fault.
No, he just said I could.
And then you're not going to be here because you ain't got the right equipment.
No, man. Please,
come on,
boss.
You didn't want to work or what?
Please, yes, sir.
Take it up with Freddie. I'm already ahead with this book.
Okay, I'm sorry, man.
I've already had it.
He said I could come back tomorrow. I've been penniless, man. I'm living out of my truck.
Well, now I'm already shorthanded.
Man, I want to work today,
you know,
boss. I want to work.
I'm already shorthanded.
But I want to work today. I do.
I mean, so,
yes, sir.
I'm steadily getting this deal.
You know, I want to work right now. The driller's really pissed off at me, but tool pusher's the main man. He says I got my job, so.
Coming up, a catastrophic failure puts everyone's jobs at risk.
There's some major probably gonna be some heads rolling.
We do appreciate it.
I hope to God that they don't come out here and start firing people.
And later. In Midland, oil man Autry Stevens is making a rare visit to his pipe yard.
You wanting to trade for stuff you need now, or you want to sell it?
With longtime friend Rooster McConaughey.
Are you going to be using this?
We could let it go for the right price.
The economy's been tough on this independent oil man. Autry's selling off pipe just to keep his company drilling and to save the roughnecks' jobs on Big Dog 28.
Yeah,
Rooster, we got kind of in a bind up in Martin County. We got 4 leases that are expiring all at the same time. These are big leases.
So if you lose them?
Yeah, we could lose $400 million potentially. I'm just trying to raise some cash by selling this some of this good casing here. Rooster, we need to work together on this deal.
I know.
I got pipe, but I need money. You got money, but you need pipe. Let's try to work out a trade or a deal here.
You've got some stuff out here that I can use. I can use some of this different oddball sizes. That's the kind of stuff I'm talking about. I don't see any reason we can't trade a bunch of stuff off it.
Yeah, I need to either get it in the ground or turn it into cash.
I can work something out that'll be good for both of us.
So it's a deal?
It's a deal.
Pound for pound.
Pound for pound.
Out on Rig 28, driller Pee-wee and the day crew have had a string of problems on the current hole. And it's about to get worse.
Something's bad luck. I don't know. We're just having a stream of it lately. Hey!
The pressure's dropped in the drill string.
We lost 100 pounds of pressure.
Like a tremor predicting a catastrophic earthquake, a pressure drop on the rig is a sign of impending disaster. Somewhere in the 2 mile deep hole, water spewing out of the pipe.
If I kick the rotary out and shut down right there.
I think we got something twisted off down there. Well, I think.
Pretty sure we twisted off.
A twist-off is the most dreaded breakdown in the oil field. In the hole, the pipe has to withstand excruciating pressure the deeper it drills. Sometimes, over-aggressive drilling or a flaw in the metal will cause the pipe to snap and bring drilling to a screeching halt.
To me, this is worst-case scenario on a hole right here. I've seen them have to abandon holes and start over. Cost people millions of dollars.
Justice on the oil field is cruel.
People get fired over this all the time.
In almost every case,
but they're gonna blame it on us.
The drillers usually blame for the twist-off. Pee-wee's only hope is the slim possibility that a faulty pipe caused the twist-off.
There's probably gonna be some heads rolled.
The only way to figure out what caused the twist-off is to pull over a mile of pipe out of the hole and inspect it.
And we're gonna start coming out of the hole one at a time.
That means tripping pipe.
I'm getting ready to go up on the board, pull some pipe back. Putting on my climbing equipment. And I'm headed to the sky.
With his job on the line, Pee-wee now has to wait for the crew's 50-year-old Derrick man to climb the rig.
We're waiting on Gerald to get up there, get on the board, and get all tied off so he can pull his pipe out of the hole. He's taking his time.
A little bit old, but I can still do it. Last time I was on the board on a big triple like this, about 20, 22 years ago.
All right. I think he'd be able to handle it all day.
When kids think they're bad, they're half my age, I still kick the deck. But yeah, if you look down there, it's about 90 foot from here to there.
All right. Here we go, number one. Yeah, keep an eye up there. Up
this
top.
Is Gerald's chance to prove he can keep up with a crew half his age.
Hey, rattle and roll. That's what we like about getting high.
But that's a tall order. Each stand of pipe is 90 feet high and weighs nearly a ton.
Hold it! He lost it. I know, hold it!
Luckily for Gerald, it's almost shift change time, and the night crew's on the way in.
Well, Tank, welcome aboard to the Big Dog 28.
Right.
And today, Tank's back and ready for action.
Whatever you do out here, don't get so aggravated that you gotta hurt somebody. If you got a problem, come to this trailer house. It's always open.
You got it, boss.
But before the day crew can hand off the rig, Gerald has to wrestle one last pipe, and the one-ton piece of steel isn't giving up without a fight.
showing off them muscles.
I was
kind of
pissed off. That's what I was.
He looks pretty crazy.
While Driller, Ron, and the night crew takes over the rig.
What all we got going? Twist off and the collar's probably somewhere.
Most likely.
They say anything about it?
Autry's called an emergency meeting in Midland.
Walter, it looks like this rig 28 had some problem here. Looks like they had a twist off.
I can't understand twisting off like that.
Could we lose a hole over this, or?
Well, we could. We just have to see if we can get latched on to the fish. Are you going to be able to make that four reels in 50 days?
Audrey, I don't know. You know, it really looks bad right now with the fish in the hole and everything. I don't know if we're going to be able to recover from this or not. If we start having trouble latching on or anything, we have to drill around it, well, that could take a week to 10 days. If that happens, we're dead.
You realize the consequences of not making that last well. We lose that acreage, and that's the end of the drilling for Rig 28. They lose their job.
Coming up, the crew races to recover their pipe.
I try to do as much as I can, mate.
But forget about safety. And later, Autry visits the site and discovers what or who caused the twist-off.
David, what about that twist-off last night? What happened out here?
While the night crew continues the hunt for the twist-off over a mile under Big Dog 28,
the consequences of not making that last well, they lose their job.
Fear of losing the well has pushed Autry to plan a trip to the drill site tomorrow morning. Now it's up to driller Ron and the night crew to find the missing pipe before the boss gets there. To make matters worse, they're working with a new hand.
Say we take a break.
Tank's an experienced roughneck, but no one knows if he'll mesh with this crew.
He may be a asshole.
Where?
The mother gets saucy, we'll have to lay him down, boys.
Up high, balls up high. Stop. Oh! He's sitting here every time he throw the tongs or he pull the sledge, boy, he's grunting and everything. Yeah. And I thought he was out there trying to take a shit or something. I guess you just do what you gotta do to motivate you.
After manhandling the one-ton stands like toothpicks, Tank's proving he's night crew material.
Yeah. This is Sparta.
With 5,000 feet of pipe out of the hole,
hey!
The crew finally pulls out one end of the twist off.
That'll do it.
I bet that's sharp as hell.
Leave me a washer for a while.
I got a washer right on this side right here.
But that's only half the job. Now they've got to recover the other half of the drill string, resting over a mile deep on the bottom of the hole.
Now we go fishing. They're bringing fishing tools out here. They're oil field tools designed to latch on to stuff. In this case, we'll probably have to use an overshot. And what that is, it looks like a drill collar, you know what I mean? It's got this grappling tool on the end of it.
Watch your fingers right there.
So we'll go down into that collar and snub into it like that, you know, and turn it a couple times and dig into it real good, and we ought to be able to pick it up, you know. It could take weeks or a day. Just depends on what's going on.
At 10 p.m., it's shift change on Big Dog 28. and the night crew's handing off the fishing job to driller Pete and the graveyard crew.
Oh! I haven't been dying to go fishing all week. I didn't know I was going to do it out here. I was going to do it in the morning on my day off.
When you got a fishing job like this, it's going to hit the fan. They're going to look at this collar.
Rig 28's dead in the water with a mangled pipe stuck at the bottom of the hull. And Big Dog's burning 50 grand every day the rig isn't drilling.
You know, they're gonna be pissed off because we twist it off. You know, when you twist off, it ain't a very good thing for anybody. Can't make no money like that if you ain't making no hole.
It don't go perfect. You know, I mean, you know, that's why it's off. There's too much on a drilling rig to go good all the time.
Pushing the roughnecks closer to unemployment.
You do what you gotta do. I got 8 hours. I try to do as much as I can tonight.
But now the broken transmission has come back to haunt the graveyard crew.
All we have is first gear and third gear. You're either going real slow or you're going really, really fast.
To do this job right, Pete needs second gear.
You get one gear for this clutch.
First gear takes too much time.
You gotta wait on that clutch. Come on, tell us. You gotta wait.
So Pete throttles the rig up to third gear.
Wait on it, wait on it. Wait on it.
Everyone knows working this fast can be deadly. But their only choice is to keep fighting for their jobs.
I thought, you know, I'm ready to put that clamp on there. Everybody basically slip out. Time to come down and make a sense. You already knew that.
Carl takes the 800-pound tongs to the head. Without his hard hat, he'd be dead. Despite the near misses, Pete and the graveyard crew keep fishing for the twist off. The scale will tell Pete if he's caught the missing drill string.
Another round.
And a sudden jump in weight tells the crew they've hooked the twist off.
What's pressure?
Oh, looky here. We're dragging a fish out of the hole. We got a big old fish on there tonight, Pete.
Well, we just got lashed onto the fish. So now we got to come out of the hole.
After 4 hours of tripping pipe,
hey, hold that air hoist for him.
They've retrieved the bottom half of the twist off.
I got it. Oh my God!
Now that all the pieces are back on the surface, an inspection will determine what or who caused the twist off. Tomorrow, heads could roll. Coming up.
I hope to God that they don't come out here and start firing people.
The bosses hit the rig.
Hey, what happened out here?
And the crews find out who's to blame. It's judgment day on Big Dog 28. Yesterday, driller Pee-wee twisted off the drill string, marking the entire crew with a bullseye.
They're gonna blame it on us.
But no one knows if it was their fault or faulty equipment. Now, owner Autry Stevens is headed out to the rig to find out who or what caused the twist off. this could be the crew's last day.
Well, Mr. Stevens is supposed to be out here this afternoon.
You leave, you show up, it's not good news.
This is a major f-up. Probably gonna be some heads roll.
It seems like I f-ed up a lot here lately with the twist off and You can sit here and drive yourself crazy and worrying about if you have a job or not. There's nothing I can do about it, just throw my clothes in the back and go on down the road.
Even if Pee-wee escapes execution, Freddie might not be so lucky. The twist-off happened on his watch.
I'm hoping that the job that we have been doing repels a little bit against what we've been having trouble with now. And I hope that he's in a good mood when he gets out here. It would be a blessing because, like they say, rolls downhill.
Now they're about to find out.
I hope to God that they don't come out here and start firing people.
Who gets a reprieve?
I'm so tired of worrying if you have a job or not right now that...
And who is going down the road?
Yeah, I look like I mean, really.
The verdict's in.
I think it had a crack. I think Inspector missed the crack.
Last night, Pete used a black light to search for microscopic cracks in the drill pipe.
Oh yeah, there, look, there's a dotted line in there. That's a big old crack.
Yeah, I can see that something from over here.
He discovered that the twist-off was caused by faulty equipment.
Why didn't they see that crack in there when they inspected it?
And not the driller.
It had a crack. Inspector just overlooked the crack.
Had those just been inspected, or?
Yes, sir.
Pee-wee dodged a bullet this time.
He made a good deal out of a bad situation.
Yes, sir.
Appreciate what y'all are doing.
Getting these wells drilled as fast as you are.
Didn't tell you to get out there. But now, we don't have any time to waste.
That's what I like to hear.
Yeah.
Pee-wee's day crew still has a job. But they haven't finished the well from hell. They're further behind than ever before, and they have one more hole to drill. Next time on Black Gold, Cheston finally catches a break.
There you go.
There you go.
Brandon drops the ball.
Y'all get out of the way!
And Freddie pushes a driller so close to the edge.
He looks dodgy, sir.
He may fall off himself.
I'm not looking forward to getting run off, but I mean, it damn sure could happen.